sight, for my monster from his slab began to rise, and suddenly, to my surprise,
I wish I could. Hi, I'm here with
Matthew.
What is the best kind of fries?
Curly fry.
Why?
Because they're curly.
What about waffle fries?
No, curly fries are better.
Why?
Because they're curly.
But what makes them better? Why is being curly better?
Because it's elite, top tier.
Didn't you cut your curly hair?
No.
Okay, thank you. Hi, I'm here with
Samantha.
What do you think is the best kind of fry?
I don't know, I eat the regular ones. Kind of
so just normal, straight cut fries. Why not curly fries?
I don't eat them often.
Why not?
I've never tried them.
Have you ever had Jack in the Box curly fries?
I've never had Jack in the Box.
You live a sad life. Thank you. Hi, I'm here with
Natalie.
What's the best kind of fry?
A curly fry.
Why?
Because it's crispy and they just taste so good.
Aren't waffle fries also crispy?
Yeah, but they don't taste the same.
But they're both potato. Why are they different?
It's just, I don't know, the seasoning or, I don't know, they're just better.
Okay, thank you.
Hello, Jaguars. My name is Devin, and on behalf of the STLs, I would like to introduce the first episode of Tech Tips for the 2023 to 2024 school year. Tech Tips will be a weekly episode that teaches you many different skills and tricks that can improve your workflow. So, let's get into it. For the first episode, I will be going over how to make custom themes for Google Slides. Now, when creating a presentation, many of us may just go straight for the default ones made by Google. But what if I told you that right in Google Slides, you're able to create your own theme in only a couple of minutes? So, without any more talk, let's see how we can do this. Here I've gone and set up a blank slideshow with the different slides that you'll be able to customize. We can see so far that they're not that appealing right now, but we can change that. The first thing that you'll want to do is go over to the slide tab, and here we can see the many different tools for customizing the slideshow. For today, let's just focus on the edit theme option. This takes us to the slide editor, which shows the many different slides that we saw before, and the way that Google has set them up by default. We can see that the first slide at the top of the editor, titled theme, is used by all slides. There are many different applications for this, but we'll just stick to the layouts for now. As I cycle through the layouts, you'll see that they highlight the slides in gray on the left that use the selected layout. But if you're a number person, you can see the total number of slides using a layout at the top here. Now enough of the fundamentals, let's actually start to set up our custom theme. I'm going to use title and body layout as an example here. And we can see the toolbar, we have many different options to start with. Let's first choose a background. I'm going to go with this gradient. Alright, now let's say I'm reporting on some high-tech science project, and we want a cool design. Let's use these shape tools for the title and body layout, and make a neat design. It looks pretty good. Now, closing the slide editor. We can see that our changes are applied to all current and future slides with the title and body layout. It's also important to note that anything you put into the theme won't interfere with your presentation. So if we have an object like this text box, we can see that we can edit it, we can move it, resize it, and do all of that. But with the theme elements, you don't have to worry about that. They're in the background. So they won't be selected, and they won't be in your way. So, I've just taught you the basics of theme editing. I suggest trying this out in your next presentation and getting creative. You've got limitless potential here. That'll be it for Tech Tips Episode 1. Next week, we'll be going over how to manage your browser tabs. Thanks for watching, and have fun creating your own custom themes.